So what is a torus? Just take one circle and you have to revolve that circle about a fixed axis without touching it. So we, whatever the surface of revolution we are getting, that is called a torus of revolution. Okay. So now let us have the next example. Show that a surface M, that is under root of x square plus y square minus 4 raised to 2 plus z square is equal to 4 is a torus of revolution. Find the profile curve and axis of revolution and hence find the parameterization of torus. So what is the question? We have to show that the whatever the M is given to us is a torus of revolution. Next, find the profile curve. That means we have to find out the circle with the help of which we are going to find out this torus of revolution. And next, we have to find out the parameterization of torus. Okay. So for that, let me have whatever given thing. What is given to us? This equation of a surface of revolution or torus of revolution. That is under root of x square plus y square minus 4 raised to 2 plus z square is equals to 4. Okay. So if you want to find out the profile curve, what we have to do is either it will be in x. That means if you see here, it will be either in xz plane or in yz plane. So if I want to say the curve, it should be in the xz plane. So y coordinate should be 0. If it is the circle is a x with the xz plane, so y is 0. If it is yz plane, then x should be 0. Since the profile curve is a circle in a plane, so this circle is either in xz plane or yz plane. If the profile curve is in xz plane, y is 0. Hence the equation is. So if y is 0, I will write x square under root of x square, that will be x minus 4 square plus z square is equal to 4. So what will be the equation of this circle? This is a circle in xz plane with center at 4 comma 0, radius is 2, right? So in this way, we can write the equation, that is x minus 2, that is r cos theta, r sin theta. Angle u, and next is z is equals to 2 sine u. So with the help of that, I can take it as x is equal to 4 plus 2 cos u, z is equal to 2 sine u, and y is 0, that we have assumed because we want a circle in a xz plane. So in the very similar way, this procedure you can do while putting x is 0. If you put x is 0, you will get a circle in yz plane and the corresponding changes. Okay. So now we have to give the name. What is the name? Our first function, that is in terms of u, is h of u is equal to 4 plus 2 cos u, and second function g of u is z is equals to 2 sin u. That is nothing but g of u is equal to 2 sin u. Now if I want to find out the parameterization, for that what we have to do, first we have to define a mapping x. Okay, x will be a mapping from d to e3. What is d in this case? D, that is open subset of a R2 space, is nothing but your circle in xz plane. That is, circle in xz plane will be the D, that is open subset of R2 space. Now x of u is equals to xyz. Now this will be the matrix that we have obtained. Okay. Now what will be the consideration now? Where the, what will be the axis of revolution in this circle is rotated about the z axis. Okay. So here we have considered that the circle is rotated about z axis. Why this is so? Because here we have taken a circle in xz plane. Okay. That is, so with the help of that, we can say the circle is rotated about a z axis. So if it is rotated about a z axis, so there will be the corresponding changes. Cos v minus sin v, sin v cos v. So here should be negative sign and the corresponding changes. So x, whatever we have got the value of x, we here, that you have to write, and then next, z is nothing but your g of u, that you have to write down. Okay. And then after doing a matrix multiplication, you will get the values. Now just put up the values of g of u and h of u, and you will get the result that is x of u v is equals to. So here we got the parameterization. Now if I want to prove this parameterization is a, that means whether this, whatever the x of u v that is mapping we have found is a parameterization or not. For that you have to just verify x u cross x v is not equal to 0. Okay. So what we have got here, x square plus whatever the values of x and y we have in this x, y and z. So with the help of that, we have to just find out x square plus y square. What will be x square plus y square? And then x square plus y square is 4 plus 2 cos u square. And then you can take a square root on both sides, taking minus 4 here, taking 4 here. So we can get the value of this. So if z is 2 sine u and this value is 2 cos u, the square of these two will be nothing but cos square plus sine square is equals to 1. But this 2 square, that will be nothing but 4. So hence, in this way, we can find out this torus of revolution. Okay. And in this next example, that is note is given to you. If you consider the circle in yz plane, what you have to consider? X should be 0. And again, the axis of revolution should be a z axis. Why this is so? Because if you select axis of revolution is z axis, then only you will have a circle in either xz plane or in a yz plane, right? No, the circle will be either in xz plane or in yz plane. Then only you will have a axis of revolution is a z axis. Okay. So these are the examples you have to solve, and this is an exercise provided to you. No doubt you have to solve the exercises. Now, what is the next example? Show that this example is a surface and defined by this parameterization. So what we have to show is whether they say surface or not. For that, I have already told you that whatever the equation you have to name it as g, and then find out dg. After finding dg, just find out whether dg is equal to 0 or non-zero. Okay, find out dg is not equal to 0 is somewhat difficult. So we will find out dg is equal to 0 at which point. And if you are getting that point in on your surface, that means that you are on the given geometric object, that means that the given geometric object is not a surface. And if you are getting dg is not equal to 0 for every point on a given geometric object or NM, then we can say that given geometric object is a surface. So for that, g is equals to, you have to write down what is g is equals to, whatever the equation we have, x square by a square plus y square by b square plus z square by c square. I hope everyone knowing about this, what will be this equation look like in the geometrically. Already I told you that you have to download an app. With the help of that, you can just put up the equation and you will get the images of that, right? So dg is equal to, we have found, as it is evaluating a partial derivative, so differentiate with respect to x, y and z. And this coefficient of dx, dy, dz, if they are equal to 0 simultaneously, then only we will get that dg is equal to 0. So as a, b, c, d are constant, so we can say that x, y, z should be equals to 0. Because we have considered a, b, c are non-zero, 2 is also non-zero. So when this dg will be equal to 0, only if x, y, z all are 0 simultaneously. But whether we have to check this point 0, 0, 0 is on the surface or not. So for that, let us take x equal to 0, y equal to 0 and z is equal to 0. So what I get here, I will get it is as 0. And what we have here, it is 1, right? So on RHS, we have 1 and on LHS, we have 0. So 0 is not equal to 1. Hence, we can say that this point 0, 0, 0 is not on the given geometric object. So if it is not belonging to M, so obviously we can say dg is not equal to 0 for all points of a surface M, because we have checked out dg is equal to 0 at which point. So only one point we are getting where the dg is equals to 0, but that point is not on the your M, and hence we can say that the given geometric object is a surface. Now what we have to prove in the next part, x of uv is equals to, now they have given you the mapping x. Now this mapping we have to find out, with the help of this we have to prove that this equation holds. Now just we have to verify whether this x square by h square plus y square by b square plus z square by c square is equals to 1. Now next, if I want to find out whether it is a parameterization, for that what we have to do, simply by using our theorem, xu cross xv is not equal to 0. Now everyone know that how to find out the derivative with respect to u, with respect to v. What is x given to us? You have to just find out the derivative with respect to u about x. So if you differentiate, what I get is a cos v will be treated as constant. What is the derivative of cos u? Will be minus sin u. Derivative of again cos u is minus sin u, and here derivative of sin u is cos u. And in the very similar way, we have to find out a derivative with respect to v, and hence we can get the result. And after getting this, we have to evaluate this determinant. And this determinant, after evaluating this determinant, this whole xu cross xv will be equal to 0 only if this whole equation is 0. That means we can say that this equation is equal to 0 only if these coordinate functions are equal to 0. And these coordinate functions will not be equal to 0 simultaneously, because sine and cos will not be equal to 0 simultaneously, the coefficient of u3. Next, here also you can say sine and cos will not be equal to 0 simultaneously. Here also v and u have different domain. So hence we can say that the xu cross xv is not equal to 0. And hence we can say that the mapping x is a regular, and hence x of v lies in a M. Okay. So hence we can say x is a parametrization. Right. So these are the examples. You have to solve those examples. Show that it's a surface. How to show this is a surface? What you have to do? X square plus y square, x square by a square plus y square by b square minus z is equal to 0. Now just find out dg. Similarly, you can solve the next example. Okay. So these are the examples you have to solve very clearly, so that you can find out whether the given object is a surface or not. It is somewhat difficult to understand, but it is very easy to do the calculations. Simply you have to find out the derivative. In the second way, what you have to do? Simply we have to put x is equal to 0 or y is equal to 0. Then you get the profile curve. After getting the profile curve, you have to find out the axis of revolution. So in this case, axis of revolution will be z, because in this equation itself, z is revolving. So you can imagine this, and we can get the axis of revolution is a z axis, and hence we can get the result. Okay. So with the help of that also, that is dt not equal to 0, you can prove the given geometric object is a surface or not. Okay. So now let me show the diagram for this, what we have. Okay, what is our equation we have is under root of x square plus y square minus 4 raised to 2 plus z square is equal to 4. X square plus minus 4 z square is equal to 4. So if I put x is equal to 0, what I get? X is 0 means under root of y square minus 4 x square plus z square is equal to 4. It means that I will get y minus 4 square plus z square is equal to 4, right? So we are getting, suppose this is our z axis, but we have a circle in yz plane. It is parallel to yz plane. Because this is your x, y, and z. What we have? Equation of a circle which is parallel to yz plane, right? So if it is parallel to yz plane or it is in yz plane, so we'll have somewhere here. So this circle, we have to revolve about a fixed axis, that is the axis, and whatever the object I am getting is nothing but the torus of revolution. So in this case, we have a circle in yz plane. Okay, you can consider the circle in yz plane. Or in another way, if you put x is equals to 0, we are getting a circle in yz plane. And if you put y is 0, what I get is x square minus 4, sorry, x minus 4 square plus z square is equal to 4. So what I get now in this case is, this is x, y, and z. So what we have a circle in xz plane. So here somewhere we will have a circle in xz plane. So this circle we have to revolve about a z axis, and whatever the object we are getting is a torus of revolution. It is just like a tube of our tire. Okay, so hence this is nothing but the geometric way how to find out whether the given object is a torus of revolution. Okay, so many more examples you can solve the exercises and all. Now let us go for the next point. What is the next point here? Now I hope you can do this example that we have seen just now. What is the m? M is nothing but x square by a square plus y square by b square plus h square by c square. I hope those who are doing a homework for them, I will ask what will be the name of this. I will give you a hint. It is just like a hyperbola, no? Hyperbola or ellipse. As it is just like looking as an ellipse, so it is called ellipsoid. As we are having equation of ellipses, x square by y square plus y square by b square is equal to some constant. But it is, now it is in terms of 3, so hence we can call it is as ellipsoid. So we have to verify whether it is a surface or not. To verify, let us name g is equal to what will be g, x square by y square plus y square by b square plus z square by c square minus 1 is equals to 0. Now we have to find out simply dg. Dg is equals to dou g by dou x dx plus dou g by dou y dy plus dou g by dou z dz. Right? So we have to just differentiate g with respect to x. What will be the differentiation? It is 2x by a square dx. What is the derivative with respect to x about over y and z? It will be 0, so no need to treat. Next is 2y dy. Right? So next, again, derivative of g with respect to y, derivative of x, partial derivative of x with respect to y will be 0, partial derivative of z with respect to y is 0. Similarly, here we have 2z upon c square dz. Okay, so hence now this whole equation will be equal to 0 only if this x, y, z is equal to 0, because 2 and a, or 2, a, b, c, all these are non-zero, because we have assumed that a, b, c are non-zero. If a, b, c would be 0, 1 upon 0 will be infinity, this equation would not be defined. Okay, so hence this will be equal to 0 only if x, y, z are equals to 0, 0, 0. So this, now we have to verify whether this point 0, 0, 0 is on the surface. So if I put 0, 0, 0 here, I am getting 0 is equal to 1, which is not true. Hence we can say that this 0, 0, 0 is not on the surface, and hence dg is not equal to 0 for every point of the surface. Because here we have found at which point dg is equal to 0. So if we are getting that point obviously it is not belonging to here, the given geometric object. Hence we can say that the given geometric object is a surface. Okay. Next, you can verify easily x u cross h v is equal to 0 or non-zero.
Madam, yeah, double to
बोलो
सर. थैंक यू मैडम. करे डबल.